Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you some hidden photo filters that are built into your Mac and how you can easily use them. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So your Mac has some image filters built into it called Quartz Composition Filters. But you don't really see these in apps. There is a way to access them using Automator. So you could build a quick little app that allows you to easily get to these filters and apply them to any image file. So let's start off here in the Automator app. And we're going to create an application. You could do this as a quick action, but I'm going to use it as an application so we can just drag and drop an image onto it. So first, I want to get that image and make a duplicate of it because this filter is going to change the image passed into it. So we don't want to change the original. It's too easy to make mistakes that way. Now you can use copy files for this, but I like using duplicate finder items better. It's simple and it will just create a copy in the same location as the original. So once we have that, let's search for Quartz. There's a bunch of things here. The one we want is apply Quartz composition filter to image files. Now if these sound familiar, you may be thinking of Quartz filters, which allow you to do things like compress PDFs. This is a little different. These are composition filters. And they do a whole variety of things. I'm going to drag this in here. And you see it's going to say, hey, this is going to change the original. Do you want to add copy finder items? We don't because we've already set up duplicate there. So I'm going to say don't add. We're fine. Now here's the Quartz composition filter action in Automator. So you can see here it's showing you a sample image and what it'll look like if it's applied. You can see there's a whole bunch of different ones, a ton of them. So for instance, blur, you could see what that looks like and that there are settings for blur. You could try color controls and there are a whole bunch of settings for color controls. You could try comic book, lots of different ones, tons of cool things that you could use to modify your images. So you'd think that we need to build a different Automator application for each one of these, but we don't actually have to do that because if we go to options here and I look under options, show this action when the workflow runs. We'll just check that. Then it's going to prompt us for all of this stuff every time we run this app. So let's now save this. So I'm just going to save it to the desktop for now. You'll probably want to put it somewhere else like your user applications folder or something like that. And I'm going to call this apply Quartz composition filter. And once I do that, I don't need Automator anymore. I now have this little app here. I've got an image file. All I need to do is drag and drop this onto it. Now the first time you do it, it's going to ask for permission to access the location where it's at. I'll say OK. And you see it comes up here with the choices we can make. Notice it's sticking with the last one that we used when we made this in Automator. So if you think you might be using, say, blur often and the other ones more rarely, then you probably want to set it to blur before you export the application. So now you could pick which filter you want. So for instance, let's take blur here. I'll set the amount to 0.2. And I can't quite read what's there, but I can actually drag the window here. Clean edge. So I could select or unselect that and continue. And you can see the duplicate file it created right here. If I quick look that, you can see it's blurred compared to the original. So let's try some others. I'll drag it into here and let's go to light tunnel. And you can see it creates that. I can change the X and Y value instead of right in the middle, 0.5. I can move it over. I can have the amount different like that or maybe more. And continue. And you could see here this copy looks like that now. There's so many cool things to try out. You're going to see a lot of these if you use a app like say Photoshop or Pixelmator or Affinity. They have a lot of these effects in there. But you probably didn't know that they were already on your Mac even without buying any of those apps. So let me use comic book. And I could see here preview mode will actually be a little bit different depending upon which one I choose. So now I can preview this one. Like here's neon. That looks pretty. And I could click here to select a different color. Great interesting things with that. There's even an image resizer. So you can use this to resize images. Let's expand the window a little bit and see the target width and height. So let's create something much smaller like that. And we can set it to crop, stretch, fit, whatever we want. So let's just do crop and a background color that will fill in the extra spaces. I'll do continue. And now we can see here we've got this new image here and it is indeed cropped to that size. Let's try it again and actually have it resize. So we'll do 200 by 200 but we'll say that it's going to fit like that. And continue. And we could see here we get a smaller version of this. So a way to quickly resize your photos. And of course this one obviously is going to be a much smaller file at 47K than this original one. So you saw how easy it was to create this in Automator. And once you do, you have all of these filters available to you. Even if you have an app that has filters like this in it, it's so quick and easy to apply one of these with the Automator application that you may want to use this instead if all you want is a quick, simple effect. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.